Hello everyone, welcome back in today's tutorial on Python. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn what is two-dimensional list and how to use in Python programming. So let's start today's tutorial. Before going to see the two-dimensional list, we need to understand the basic concept about the dimensions. In mathematics or in physics, you might have learned this kind of concept, one-dimensional, two-dimensional and three-dimensional. Any object which can be defined in one dimension is called as a one-dimensional. For example, a line, a period or a dot, those are the one-dimensional objects. The two-dimensional has two direction. So any object which can be defined by two direction is called as a two-dimensional. For example, if you're drawing rectangle or triangle with the height and length, so that means it has the two dimensions. Most of the real-time objects such as human being or a tree or a house, those are the three-dimensional object, which has the, in the three-dimensional object case, the object will be defined by the three dimensions. Of course, there are some other dimensions also there, like the four dimension where the time is also considered. But for programming perspective, we need to understand what is the one dimension, two dimension and three dimensions. As a part of today's tutorial, we are going to learn the two dimensions, because one dimension we already seen. What is that? Yes, we'll see that quickly. What is the one dimension which we saw already? Three dimension we'll see in the upcoming tutorial, how can we use in the Python. If you remember, we created a list of variable by defining some values in that list. It's an example of a one dimension, because each attribute we can retrieve individually. We don't need the other dimension to retrieve. Like if I give index 0, it will return the India from that given list. So it is just one dimension. The two dimension example is, suppose if you create a region list like North America region, Asia specific region or Europe region. In each region there will be several countries. For example, in North America region we will have the US and Canada. In Asia specific region will have the India, China and other countries. European region will have the UK, Germany, France, etc. So if you see our list of region, we have the multiple regions, and within the single region we can have the multiple countries. So here we see the two dimension. One dimension is nothing but the list of region, and other dimension is nothing but the list of countries. So there are two dimension exists, so it's called as a two dimensional. Three dimensional example we'll see in our upcoming tutorial. So our today's focus will be on how to work with this two dimensional object. The two dimensional objects or two dimensional variables comes with the two types of values, and which are arranged in rows and columns. For example, in 2D list we'll have the columns and rows. Rows will start with index 0 and then it will increment by 1 and it will become 1, 2, 3 and so on. Column will also start with index 0 and it will increase to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So we have to always keep in mind the indexes always start with 0 for a first column or first row. So these are the details about the two dimensional. Let's have a look on the practical example. So in order to demonstrate, let's create a region list which we just saw in our PPT. So I'll create a list here. This is called a region list. Suppose we have the North America region. In North America region we'll have the two countries, for example US and Canada. There might be other countries, but we will not include for the demo. Let's add some Asia-specific countries, for example, India and China. We'll add some European region countries, UK, you can add Germany or France, whatever you like. Let's add Germany. So this is a list of region which contains a list of countries. Now suppose the requirement is retrieve the India value from this region list. How can we do that? In order to do that, we have to create first of the index. We know the index of this value is 0 because that is the first row. Here I will explain you how it works. As I said, the two dimensional is nothing but it is a list. So the first row is US, Canada, second row is India, China, and third row is UK, Germany. We have the column which start with US, India, and UK. Column second is Canada, China, and Germany. We are saying the row 1 and column 1, but it will start with the index 0. So 0th index for row is US, 0th index for column 0 is US. So if I retrieve region list and provide the index 0, that is the row, and I have to also specify the index for column. So index of row and index of column is 0, so it will print US as in result. That is what we got. Now suppose if I want to print India, then I have to use the row first, that is it is a 0th index row, and the column is 1. So this time it will print, column is 0 and row is 1. So row is 1 because this will start with the 0 row, first row, 0th index of row, first index of row, and second index of row. This is 0th column and this is first column. So I'll use, if I want to retrieve India, so it is nothing but the index 1 row and index 0 column. So it will print India. Right now, if you notice here, we are hard coding these values. How can we achieve this, the same result, dynamically? And here is the concept of the nested loop will comes into the picture. So if we have the multiple iterative values within itself, multiple values, then we have to use the nested loop. We'll use a for loop here, for, and I will just mention region in region list. So here I will print all the regions. So suppose if I print region, it will print the list of all regions. So you can see the US, Canada is one region, India, China is other region, and third is UK, Germany. So we got the region, but we don't want region. What we want, suppose I want to print India. So what we need to do? We need to print all the values. So here we'll use nested loop again, and this time we'll use the country in region. So in each region there are countries present, so we'll get those countries and we'll print here. So if I print now, I'll see all the countries are printed. So here we insert accessing each value by defining its index for column and row, we are actually iterating over a region first, and then we are region list first, and then we are iterating again on countries list, and that way we are able to return the value. Now here, if you can just specify condition, if country equals to India, just print your country is, something like that. And it will print your country is India. So it will just match one value and it will return the result. So if you have the two-dimensional array or two-dimensional list, you have to use the theme or the nested loop. That is the use of the nested loop with the two-dimensional list. So in this tutorial we learn what is two-dimensional list, how to create a two-dimensional list, how to retrieve the values from two-dimensional list using direct indexing, or how can you retrieve the values by using nested loop. I hope this simple tutorial help you to understand the two-dimensional concept in Python. If you have any questions or queries, you can definitely mention in the comment section of this video. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice time.